गुड मॉर्निंग चिल्ड्रन, ओपन योर बुक्स पेज नंबर 130 एंड टुडे विल कंटिन्यू विद डिहाइड्रेशन. सम ड्राइड फूड आइटम्स लाइक पोटैटो चिप्स, सेवई, वर्मिसली, यू नो यू मस्ट बी हर्ड हैव सीन ऑल्सो वॉट इज वर्मिसली, दैट इज सेवई. ईद इज कमिंग एंड एवरीबडी मस्ट बी गेटिंग रेडी टू प्रिपेयर सेवई. फेनोग्रीक, दैट इज मेथी, कॉलीफ्लावर, पापड़ और अनियन आर स्टोर्ड इन द किचन फॉर अ पीरियड ऑफ 1 year. You know, if we have done the preservation part with these fruits or vegetables by dehydration, you can keep it for the period of 1 year or more than that. These are food items which have been preserved by the dehydration method. These items we have preserved by dehydration method. And you know what is dehydration? The word dehydration means removing water or moisture from food. When water is removed from food or moisture should not be there in the food item, then the food item is said that it is being dehydrated. The home method of dehydration is sun drying. Usually people do the sun drying method for dehydration. We will now discuss this method in detail. Some food items like green leafy vegetables, methi, pudina, coriander, etc., cauliflower, grapes, amla, onion and raw mango are dried. These all items are done dried, and this is mainly done by dehydration method. Some food are cooked and then dried. Usually we dry it and then we cook it, but for some vegetables first we cook it and then we dry it. For example, potato chips, papad, banana chips and vadis, we all first we cook it, then we dry it, do the dehydration part, and then it is ready for preparation. The most appropriate weather to dry foods is when the air is dry. Appropriate weather to dry is when the air is fully dry and there is strong sunshine. When the sunshine is very strong, usually in summers, you can do all these things for dehydration purpose. Then the method of dehydration. What is the method of dehydration? Please go through it nicely. Read each point nicely, and in case you see you have not been able to understand anything, we'll discuss. And then what is the method of dehydration? Fenugreek. How to dehydrate fenugreek by dehydration method and making potato chips. You know, first you have to cook, boil potato, and then you have to make the chips. But that is papad, in which you boil potatoes. For chips, you immediately cut and put in salt water and then you dry it. So these are the methods of dehydration, of fenugreek and potato chips. You can go through it, okay? Then some useful chips. Take care of hygiene while preparing the food and storing. You have to be very careful. You have to be prepare the food items by preparing it in a good hygienic condition. The utensils and container used to cook and store food items should be thoroughly, whatever utensils you are using, it should be thoroughly washed and cleaned and dried in sun. After drying it properly, only you can use it for your purpose. The container should have airtight lids, and the air lid should be completely airtight so that no moisture may go inside. Because if in the presence of moisture, things will again become spoiled. While preserving pickles, take care that a layer of oil is above the vegetable so that these do not come in contact with the air. You have to be very careful while you're making pickles that the layer of oil is above the vegetable. Above the vegetable, the air oil should be there so that these may not come in contact with the air, so that the air which is present in the bottle may not come in contact with the vegetable or fruit, whatever you are going to preserve it. While using the preserved food items, take care to use clean spoon, and always you should, when you are going to take out the food particles from the can, should always use clean spoons. The lid immediately after removing the required quantity, and after you have taken out the required quantity, immediately close the lid so that less moisture content may be inside, because if more of the moisture content will be there, then the contents may be spoiled. For food like sauces and squashes, the bottles should be sterilized and kept in hot water till they are needed. For the canning and for the sauce and for the squashes, bottles should be sterilized very nicely, because if there be moisture content in that, the food particles will tend to get spoiled. You first put the preserved food in the bottle and then sterilize the bottle by heating them in the water for 30 to 40 minutes. So again, after the keeping the food also, you have to do the sterilization part, so that the moisture content may not be in the bottle. Then method of commercial food preservation. Now we'll see the what are the commercial methods of food preservation. Commercially means when you're doing the things for a large quantity, for a bulk of the materials. Canning. The canning is here the food stuff to be preserved is packed in hermetically sealed containers. This is fully clean and kept in isolation. Those containers can be used, thus preventing direct contact between microorganism latent air and the foodstuff, because it has to be kept isolated, because it should not be come in contact with the air or with the moisture. It is essential that before sealing that all air entrapped is completely exhausted. And before sealing, you have to see that all the air present in the container should be completely exhausted and entrapped. Besides, these containers are heated for a specific period of time. At the same time, they are also being heated after the after you have put the contents to it, so that the microorganisms present in the foodstuffs are likely to prevent spoilage. So that the microorganisms which were present in the foodstuffs may not make the food spoil, and foodstuffs are killed to prevent spoilage, and they are also being killed so that no spoilage is being done. The containers are then cooled immediately after the boiling of the containers. It is immediately cooled because to prevent loss of color, texture and taste. It is immediately done after the boiling. It is immediately cooled so that there is no loss of color, texture and taste of food, which may have been affected by slow and prolonged heating. And then if you have done the heating part and then immediately you'll do the cooling part, then it will not do it, will the color and texture will not be affected. Then bottling. When glass jars and bottles are used instead of cans in the above mentioned process, this is termed as bottling. If you are using bottles instead of cans, it is bottling. Then what is blanching? This the method of heating fruits and vegetables for some time in boiling water or steam is known as blanching. Suppose you have to preserve the food items for a period of time. Before preserving it, you will do this blanching method. You will heat fruits and vegetables for some time in boiling water. You will keep the fruits and vegetables for some time in the boiling water or steam, and then you will take out after some time. This is known as blanching. It is used as pre-treatment in canning and drying a vegetable. This is the pre-treatment before drying and canning the vegetable. This process makes the vegetable soft. And what happens after doing this blanching? The vegetables become soft, rendering easy packing in cans. It becomes soft. It can easily be packed in the cans. At the same time, the tissues also become softens. Of the softening of the tissues also permits the escape of moisture more easily. Because of the tissues, they become so soft, the moisture escapes from it easily in drying this. And the quality of the product or reconstitution is also good, and the quality of the product is also maintained. Blanching fixes the color of the vegetable. After blanching is being done, you'll see the color of the vegetables just the same. Besides helping in the removal of acid, that is, it is acid, not acrid, helping in the removal of acid, undesirable taste and flavor, and also the air trapped in the tissues of the vegetables. What happens? After blanching fixes the color of the vegetable, besides helping in the removal of acids, what happens? Undesirable taste and flavors, and also the air trapped in the tissues of the vegetables are also removed. So no undesirable taste is there, and flavors and also is remain the same, and the air trapped in the tissues of the vegetables is gone because of this blanching. Blanching also lowers the load of microorganisms. So the microorganisms are also lower while becomes less while we do the blanching process for the preservation part. Covering liquid, usually only the container are filled to 2/3 of their capacity. The remaining space is occupied by water. When you are doing the canning or bottling, what you will do, you will usually fill the container to the 2/3 of their capacity, and the remaining space is occupied by water. Remaining space is occupied by, you'll fill it with water, with brine. Brine is salty water, sugar syrup or fruit juice. Because food should not be come in contact with air directly. That's why it is for pickles you cover usually with oil, and for other items, for canning and bottling, you will cover it with water and brine, salt water or sugar water. Because it improves the color, flavors and taste of the canned or the bottled foodstuffs. We do this because we have to retain the color, flavor and taste of the products which is being bottled. Besides facilitating destruction of microorganisms, at the same time it facilitates the destruction of microorganisms as they allow easy and even penetration of heat throughout the container, conventional currents. What happens? Because what happens? This facilitates the destruction of microorganisms because they allow easy and even penetration of heat throughout the container. Because when heat is not there, they can be easily penetrate and go inside the food. That's why the heating is must. Then solid packs. In the canning process, when the foodstuffs are packed without any covering liquid, or if you are covering with the liquid or brine or the sugar part, fine. If you're not doing with any liquid, what happens? You can cover it with salt or sugar in the place of covering liquid, powdered salt or sugar. The product is termed as solid pack. So this is termed as solid pack. You can also preserve items by covering it with salt powder or sugar, powder sugar. And then jelly. This is prepared by concentrating the pectin extract with sugar. You know, in ripe fruits, in ripe fruits we find chemical substances belonging to carbohydrate, that is known as pectin. And this pectin is very important because it helps in setting of the jelly and jam. So what happens? This jelly is prepared by concentrating the pectin extract with sugar and acid. When this pectin extract is cooked with sugar and acid to such an end point that on cooking it sets like curd. When it is cooked in the presence of acid and sugar, it is after the end point, you will see it has been set like a curd. The pectin extract is obtained by boiling the fruit alone. This extract can be obtained by boiling the fruit alone or with sufficient water or with or without added acid sometimes. At times you have to add acid also just to gain the pectin extract, and otherwise you can, it is not necessary that you have to add acid. You can also you can boil with water and then you can get this pectin extract. Jelly is transparent, having an attractive color and a pleasing taste. You will see in the two difference between jam and jelly, that jelly is always transparent, at the same time jam is not transparent. It should not stick to the fingers. If you touch the jelly, it will not stick to your fingers. Jam will stick to your fingers. And when touched with hand, it does not flow with the container. It is tilted. You will see the jelly will not flow with the container if tilted. It quivers gently on shaking and leaves sharp edges in cutting. And if you will cut the jelly, it will leave the sharp edges. These are essential constituents of a good jelly. You will see what all things will be present with if you will have a good jelly. The rate of formation of jelly is influenced by the concentration of pectin. If the concentration of pectin is good, then the jelly will set out nicely and you will see a good jelly formation in the solutions. Because constitution of pectin, hydrogen ion concentration, pH of the pectin solutions, concentration of sugar in solution, temperature of the mixture, because it will come in contact with acid and it will also come into contact with water, and you'll get a nice jelly or set in a nice manner. Then foaming of the jelly during boiling can be controlled by adding the pan a small quantity of edible oil. Suppose you have to do the foaming. Foaming is what? Foaming of the jelly is done during boiling, can be controlled by adding to the pan a small quantity of edible oil. You know, when you boil the fruits for making jam or jelly, foam comes out. Just to avoid that, you can add a teaspoon of edible oil, then it will not do the then foaming can be avoided. Generally, 1 teaspoon of oil is sufficient for the batch containing 45.3 kg sugar. And jam, when fruit pulp is used instead of pectin. Here, when we were making jelly, we were using pectin extract. We were mixing it with sugar and acid, and then we're making the jelly part. But in jam, what happens? We are using the fruit pulp instead of pectin extract. Then the product is called jam. The process followed is akin to jelly making. Jam is prepared from the fruit pulp or crushed food, or used for spreading or on toast, bread, chapati, etc. They contain added acid for taste and flavor. For jam, you have to add acid for making it nice taste and flavor. What acid? Citric acid. At times, to make it more, you know, citric acid, nibu, like why we add a lime to anything, just to make it making more tasty. Then this is the precautions in making jam. You have to go through it, the precautions in making jam, and also what is the determination by sheet and ladle test. What is ladle test and what is cold plate test and sheet or flake test. These are the three tests which we are able to do when we are making jam. I don't know whether chashni banate to aap dekhte na, test karte hain usko haath se chhuke karte hain, ek tar ki chashni, do char ki chashni, waise isme bhi kya kehte hain, we usually do the ladle test. Hum jis ladle se spoon se karte hain usko upar utha ke dekhte hain ki wo jo uska sheet ban ke aa raha hai wo kaisa aa raha hai. Fir uske baad cold plate hum cold pani mein dal ke dekhte hain, agar wo upar aa jata hai means डन. नीचे रहता है तो जैसे हम बेसिन वगैरह को करते हैं तो विल सी कि वो अच्छे से फिट गया है कि नहीं. शीट और फ्लेक टेस्ट, उसकी वो शीट की तरह हम देखते हैं जैम और जेली, जैम को निकाल के कि वो अच्छे से शीट की तरह फॉर्म कर रहा है, एंड देन यू कैन से कि हाँ इट इज़ डन. दिस पेक्टिन एक्सट्रैक्ट, यू नो वट इज़ दिस पेक्टिन एक्सट्रैक्ट, वी हैव डन दिस, यू यूज दिस पेक्टिन एक्सट्रैक्ट टू सी द 10th पॉइंट. Pectin is a chemical substance belonging to the carbohydrate group. This pectin is was a chemical substance, and it belongs to the carbohydrate group, generally found in fruit and vegetable tissues. It is mainly found in the tissues of fruits and vegetables. It is soluble in water and forms a gel. Yes, water mein soluble hota hai aur ek gel ke formation mein aa jata hai when combined in a particular proportion of sugar and acid. जेल के फॉर्मेशन में आता है जब इसको शुगर या एसिड के साथ कंबाइन करते हैं, और जेली में हम इसको शुगर और एसिड के साथ कंबाइन करते हैं. इन अनराइप फ्रूट्स पेक्टिन अकर्स एज पेक्टोज. जो कच्चे फ्रूट होते हैं, अनराइप होते हैं, उसमें पेक्टिन जो होता है किस फॉर्म में होता है? स्पेक्टोज और प्रोटोपेक्टिन एंड एस्पेक्टिक एसिड इन ओवरराइप फ्रूट, और पेक्टिक एसिड के रूप में होता है व्हेन इट इज फूड इज वेल राइपेंड. अगर अच्छे से राइपेंड होता है, ओवर राइपेंड होता है, उसमें पेक्टिक एसिड के फॉर्म में दिस पेक्टिन होता है. पेक्टोज चेंजेस इनटू पेक्टिन एंड पेक्टिक फर्दर. पेक्टोज जो होता है उसको पहले पेक्टिन में बदलता है, फिर पेक्टिन इनटू पेक्टिन, एंड पेक्टिन फर्दर इज कन्वर्टेड टू पेक्टिक एसिड, फिर पेक्टिक एसिड में कन्वर्ट करता है. ऐसे पेक्टिक एसिड ड्यू टू एंजाइमिक एक्टिविटी और बाय हीट ट्रीटमेंट इन द प्रेजेंस ऑफ एसिड. वो पेक्टिक एसिड में कंटेंट जब कन्वर्ट हो जाता है, देन इट कैन बी इजीली बी डन विद एसिड और शुगर फॉर द मेकिंग ऑफ जैम. ओनली पेक्टिन पोजेसेस द प्रॉपर्टी ऑफ सेटिंग जेली. अगर पेक्टिन
कंस्ट्रेंट अच्छे से आपके फ्रूट में होगा तो अच्छे से जेली बनेगा, अगर उसमें नहीं अच्छे से होगा तो जेली अच्छे से सेट नहीं होगा। पेक्टिन एक्सट्रैक्टेड एंड अवेलेबल इन पाउडर फॉर्म, पेक्टिन को हम पाउडर फॉर्म में भी अवेलेबल है, इसको एक्सट्रैक्ट को हम पाउडर फॉर्म में कमर्शियली यूज़ करते हैं कमर्शियल जेली बनाने में, मिक्स्ड विद जेलेटिन शुगर एसेंस एंड प्रिजर्वेटिव, जो जेलेटिन्स होते हैं शुगर एसेंस होते हैं या प्रिजर्वेटिव होते हैं उसमें हम मिक्स करके इसको हम यूज़ करते हैं पेक्टिन को। तो यू सी पेक्टिन इज़ वेरी वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट एंड यूजुअली फाइंड इन ड्राई फ्रूट्स, अन ड्राई फ्रूट्स में इट पेक्टोज में होता है, फिर वो पेक्टिन में बनता है, देन पेक्टिव एसिड में आता है एंड देन इट इज़ यूज फॉर मेकिंग जैम एंड जेली। तो आई होप दिस इज़ क्लियर टू यू ऑल एंड टुमारो विल कंटिन्यू विद 8th पॉइंट, दैट इज़ मामलेट। ओके।